Oklahoma. Also here locally, there could be a dangerous side effect from those wildfires, the ones that we happen to have recently. And here to tell us more, Dr. Daryl Miller, incoming board president of the American Heart Association of Palm Beach County. Welcome. Thank you for making some time for us. A couple weeks ago, we know Martin County, also suburban West Palm Beach County, we had some wildfires, and now perhaps a spike in ER visits because of the smoke.
That's exactly right. So we've noticed that wildfires have in general increased in intensity and duration, and the health impacts are significant. We've always known that there have been lung problems related to smoke inhalation, and inconsistent studies confirming correlation with heart and vascular issues. However, this recent study that looked at data from 2015 California wildfires has shown a definite correlation between heart and vascular and neurological issues as it relates to wildfires, particularly within that first day of dense smoke exposure.
Oh, wow. I know this particular study focused on people 65 or older. I believe we have the statistics here. ER visits usually increase roughly 42%. This is for heart attacks, and then 22% for heart disease. Is that?
That's correct. So within that first day, particularly in that elderly population above 65 years, we've noticed a definite increase in risk of heart attacks and heart-related issues as it relates to the smoke exposure, which, as we know, has got significant fine particulate matter and ozone and carbon monoxide, and all of that impacts health significantly, and this study has confirmed that there's a direct correlation.
So not much we can do about the smoke now, at least for now. It's cleared in our area, but is there something we can do to make sure that we don't end up in the ER?
That's exactly what the study has pointed out. So we need to focus on channeling more research and resources to these types of issues that have direct health impacts. And I think for the most part, the study has pointed out the need for preventing these ER visits. And that's the challenge, is trying to figure out what we can do to help prevent this issue occurring, particularly in our elderly population.
Sure. All right. Dr. Miller, thank you so much for your
time
today.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it.